Why do you need to prune a mango tree?
पिछले वर्ष करना था ये, अभी एक वर्ष लेट हो गया.
So after the total harvest of mangoes is over, then we do this pruning.
Why do you need to prune a mango tree? You could very well let the tree grow wild and you will still get fruits. But the fruit harvesting becomes difficult at unreachable heights and the yield starts reducing in spite of the trees getting bigger. Pruning is also done for other reasons. To maintain the tree at a manageable height of 12 to 15 feet, so agronomic practices like spraying, weeding, harvesting is easier. More trees can be accommodated in a given area, hence increasing productivity, to allow more sunlight into the canopy and thereby aiding increased yield. First, we did a mild pruning on our 18-month-old saplings, like how it is done on mature trees post the harvest of mangoes.
पहला एक फुट में
इन वन फीट इंग्लिश होगी
एक ही में बोलिए किसान लोगों को कैसे समझ में आएगा
तो
हम लोगों को कैसे समझ में आएगा
ये तो पिछले वर्ष करना था ये अभी एक वर्ष लेट हो गया
एक साल लेट हो गया
अभी एक फुट में काटना था ये
अच्छा
लेकिन अभी बड़ा हो गया इसलिए हम इस यहाँ से
दो फुट
यहाँ से चार पाँच निकल रहा है यहाँ से तो हम जहाँ भी वी शेप में हाँ होता है जो अंदर जाता है वो हम काटेंगे क्योंकि अंदर हमको बुशी नहीं होने चाहिए स्प्रेड होके होना चाहिए तो जो अंदर जा रहा है
तो हाँ वो काटेंगे.
Ideally, always the cut should be made at a 45-degree angle so that any water droplets that falls on it will flow away from the cut areas. I was making straight cuts because we were covering up the cut areas with gobar neem paste and a plastic cover because of the rains.
ये जो ऊपर जा रहा है वो भी हम काटेंगे अभी और इसमें भी जहां ब्रांचेस हो रहे हैं बाहर जो हो रहा है हम छोड़ देंगे जो अंदर का हो रहा है Usually it is done in the month of June after the harvest of mango. Usually it starts, the flowering starts from February, March onwards and the fruits are there till April, May, June. So after the total harvest of mangoes is over, then we do this pruning. Because this is a small plant, we are just doing it right away.
Later when I visited the Indian Institute of Horticulture Research in Bangalore, and saw the high density planting of mangoes, we decided to prune them and maintain them that way. The advantage being that the canopy will cover less of our plantable land area.
So last time what we pruned, we cut this off and left one branch here. Now these new shoots, we don't want them to come because we want these two to develop into woody branches. So I'm just clipping off the smaller ones. Right close to the tree and here I search for the node, the first node from where the branches started. This is where it is and we make a cut there. This already we have made a cut and 3-4 branches have come. We want to leave only here is 2, so next we want to leave 3. So we'll select 3 out of this 4. So how I select is whatever is going inward I cut it off because we don't want the inside of the tree to get crowded. And these 3, we'll let them grow. This we just did a month back and this is the second pruning because last time we thought we'll do a moderate pruning but this time we decided we'll make it because last year we could not prune it because of the lockdown. We have left it to grow wild. Now we are cutting it down to the basics. We are choosing 2 branches or 3 branches and after if it bifurcates, again we are leaving 2 or 3 based on what we have left first. If it is 2, then we are leaving 3. If we leave 3 at the bottom, then for each branch we are leaving 2. So this is a 1.5 year, 18 months old mango sapling. We did not prune it last year because of the lockdown. We should have pruned it when it is just around 1.5 to 2.5 feet. Because after a year we are pruning, now it has become woody here. But still we want to retain, we can either choose to just leave these two and cut these two off, or keep these three because these three are moving away from the center. This definitely I will be removing because it is growing straight up and it looks weak compared to the other three. I'll do a two and then up three. Whatever branches you are removing, you can chop it into pieces and put it at the base itself so it acts as mulching. You see this node here, this is where the new branches will be coming. So these are leaf marks and this is a node mark. So node is the place where you will see bunch of things coming up. Within a week or so, you will notice that bunch of leaves come up. So that is, and here after an inch, you leave and then make a cut. At this node, we will leave at this node and make a cut just 1 inch above that. This node here that you see. This node that you see here. From this, we will leave 1 inch and then make a cut. So this, till here the stem has already changed woody and here it's still green. So you want to cut here so that we have the new branches coming from here. So this cut part, you can, because we don't want to add chemicals which are fungicides, we would cover this with neem paste and gobar, cow dung and neem paste. And then because it's raining right now, we will probably cover it with a plastic cover as well. Just for a week or so till this resins dry up. Otherwise, the water tends to go inside and this area may start drying up or rotting. In saplings where you see branches coming right from the base, if this is a grafted sapling, definitely we should remove it because that branch could be coming from the lower stump rather than the grafted branch. And now anyway, we want to leave one main branch, so we are cutting that out. And whatever the smaller ones are there, we are chopping that off as well. Now this is a typical tree forking which has happened, so we will leave this at three. So we will select the first node and then cut it off after an inch. So this is the node where I want to leave it and I'll cut it here. And here the first node is here, so we'll make a cut here. As far as possible, we should ensure that we don't leave stuff like this on the stump and make a clear cut and then cover it up with neem paste and gobar and cover it with a polythene sheet. And here I'm cutting it at this node here. Cut my hand. So here we see like five branches coming off from this node here. So we want to trim it down to three, which is going in three different directions. Definitely we want to remove the one which is going straight up. We don't want the tree to be going tall. We want it to spread and stay at a minimal height. So we'll remove the branches which in three different directions. So I'm removing this one. This seems to be a little damaged and flat. Looking at the outside, as it was flat, I guessed that it must be a unhealthy branch, and it turned out to be right. So whatever looks good, that is the only guess we can do. And this definitely needs to be treated with neem. Bas.
After 4-5 days, we removed the plastic covers carefully, making sure not to damage the emerging buds. Because we had very few plants, it was possible to do this. Otherwise, in a large plantation, such a practice would not be feasible or advisable. Better to make the cuts at 45 degrees and apply a paste. After 10 days, you can find 5 to 8 branches have shot up from the node. The thinning can be done once the fresh brown shoots turn green, so as to ensure they are healthy and vigorous. But here I am demonstrating thinning of branches to 2 to 3 numbers even when they are tender. This pruning method will be repeated every 6 months, once after harvest in May-June and another 8 weeks before flowering in November-December. This will give an ideally shaped low tree with optimum fruiting.